Hey everyone, Grant K for the Flame Learning Channel. In this video, we'll start looking at physical-based rendering in action. The point of physical-based rendering, or PBR, is that it simulates the natural interactions of light rays and real-world materials. This allows for consistent and predictable results with textures, even if the lighting conditions are changed in the 3D environment. PBR is normally combined with image-based lighting, which allows the textures to pick up the colors from a surrounding environment. So even if the lighting is day or night, indoors or outdoors, you're able to create realistic results quickly. The model I'm about to use is courtesy of TurboSquid. You can purchase this model and many others by visiting their website at www.turbosquid.com. So we have a fresh action composite, and the first thing we'll do is bring in the 3D model. Using the import node in the action node bin, we'll navigate to the FBX file in the file browser. Now I'm going to import and convert the geometry into action objects, and we'll also autofit the geometry into the scene to ensure it's scaled correctly to the composite. When we load the geometry, it will appear front-facing in the 3D composite. In case you're wondering what this is a 3D door knocker that has been imported with its own texture. If we switch to the 2-up view and look at the action schematic, you can see the node flow graph that forms the construction of this 3D model. There are lots of geometric shapes, and they are all textured with a single texture map. Because the model is broken down like this, later on we'll be able to retexture separate components of the model. Now this model is currently lit with a general shading. You can go to the action node bin and add a light into the composite in order to control the shading in the 3D scene. But if you want to simulate lighting from a particular environment, the better suggestion is to use image-based lighting or IBL. And as I mentioned earlier, IBLs go hand in hand with physical-based shading to accurately light the 3D model with the correct colors. So to add the IBL to the scene, delete any lights you may have created and select the current 3D camera. Now go to the action node bin. In the media list, if possible, select an empty slot. If you don't do this, then the IBL will pull the selected image in the media list as an IBL source. Now switch to the Maps tab and drag out the IBL. The lighting will immediately change on the model because it is being lit by the color values in the IBL. Double-click on the IBL map and choose the Read File menu. Now you can use a media input as an IBL, or you can load an external texture. When you click Load, you will be presented with four HDRI EXR images that are included with the Flame 2017 Extension 1 install. You can use these, but you can also use your own. Now we'll stick with Stuttgart for now. In order to see the context of the image-based lighting, switch to the Controls menu and enable Users Back. The IBL is wrapped around a sphere and the lighting is projected onto the 3D model. This surrounding projection is a preview tool to ascertain where light is coming from. So if we orbit the world to the back of the model, we can see the front of the model was dark because the lighting of the IBL is coming from behind the model. So we can rotate the IBL in the 3D scene to angle the lighting to our needs. So the sun is now in front of the 3D model, and you can see how this has influenced the shading on the 3D model. Now admittedly, this does look really good, but this is not physical-based shading. The IBL can light both standard shading and PBR shading in the 3D composite. For all objects using standard shading in the 3D scene, the IBL has basic controls to adjust how standard shading reacts to the lighting. Although this is technically not correct, you can still get some great creative looks from this. As for the IBL in the context of physical-based rendering, the lighting will be dependent on the material roughness. so the IBL can produce a range of lighting from mirror-like lighting to very diffuse lighting based on the roughness controls of the PBR material. You'll see this very shortly. We'll leave the IBL background enabled to keep track of the lighting, but normally you would turn this off if you were compositing on a background plate. Now, in order to apply physical-based rendering to the 3D model, we need to change the shading pipeline. This is done using a shader node. Select the head geometry node in the action schematic. Go to the action node bin menu and locate the shader node. Drag the shader node into the action schematic and it will attach itself to the selected geometry. The shader node can be used on multiple objects, so hold Shift and L and kiss the shader node to all the geometry components of the 3D model. Once this step is completed, the shading on the geometry will change again. If you double-click on the shader node, you will see that it has defaulted to the physical-based shader that is applying PBR to this 3D model. So if we orbit around the 3D scene, this 3D model is being lit by the IBL attached to the camera, and using the PBR shader, it is reacting in a very natural and realistic way to the lighting. Now, there are two kinds of physical-based rendering, and there is loads of detailed information available on the internet. In the case of flame, we are using the metallic and roughness shading model. So in artistic terms, you can dictate how light reflects off the surface, if the material has a rough or smooth quality, and you can also dictate how metallic the material can be in order to make it shiny or not. Here are some examples of how quickly you can change the look of the materials. Setting a low roughness value makes the material smooth, and increasing the metallic surface makes the material look like a very polished metal. If you increase the roughness alongside the metallic value, the material still has a metallic feel, but it is less reflective, giving it more of a brushed metal look. And finally, if we leave the high roughness value and reduce the metallic value, the material reacts like stone or concrete. So it's really easy to experiment with the PBR shader to simulate real-world materials and naturally interact with lighting based on an IBL. Let's look at the difference with and without the PBR shader. So this is what we have using physical-based rendering. And if you toggle the shader node on or off with H, this is what you get without using the PBR shading model. And this is what you get with the PBR shading model. It's quite a massive difference in terms of material realism and light interaction. We'll leave the shader node enabled. Let's have a look at the material when the IBL is different. Double-click on the IBL node attached to the camera and switch to the Read File menu. Click the Load button, and this time choose the Empty Lab OpenEXR and load it. So now we are using an IBL that recreates indoor lighting, and the material still gives the same result, but under different lighting conditions. Let's just increase the brightness of the image-based lighting on the 3D geometry. Switch to the Controls menu and set the gain to 120. So this is the advantage of PBR. The results will always be realistic, consistent, and predictable. Now, before we move on to the next PBR video, I want to point out that you can have multiple shader nodes in the scene connected to different geometries. This allows you to control the shading on each component of the 3D model. So to set this up, go back to the shader node menu, and we'll make the material very metallic and shiny with a low roughness and high metallic value. Now we want the head of the lion and the box to have completely different shading properties. So go back to the action node bin and drag out a second shader node into the action schematic. Now you can only have one shader node connection per geometry. so press and hold the L for the lighting link, and disconnect the head and box geometries from the original shader node. Next, still holding the L keyboard shortcut, create new lighting links from the shader node to the head and box geometry nodes. Double-click on the second shader node and set a high roughness value and set a low metallic value. This will make the two materials distinctly different. So if we orbit the camera with Alt, you can see the head and box use a non-reflective stone-like material, and the eyes, teeth, and ring in the mouth are using a highly reflective polished metal. Double-click on the IBL map and disable Users Back in the Controls menu. So physical-based rendering, in conjunction with image-based lighting, brings a whole new approach to shading objects in action. You can set up your shading to match real-world materials, and even use different lighting environments, and the textures will always look great and consistent. In an upcoming video on PBR in action, we'll look at the shader node properties in slightly more detail, as well as the PBS map, which allows you to control the various properties of physical-based rendering through a texture. Be sure to check out the other features, workflows, and updates to the Flame 2017 Extension 1 products. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos.